our discus that we caught in Rio Nanay.
That is massive. I've never seen
anything
like that.
This is a big old male.
Wow, wow, wow. Yeah, that's the color on that geo is just amazing.
This is an undescribed species of Epistogramma. So here's the female.
So we're across the street at the Amazon Research Center, the kind of facility manager's property where he's got numerous breeding ponds right now. It's a little dry. Sounds like they were full last week, but I mean, really cool to walk around and see these ponds.
There's a common Laura carriage.
Mm. I do like saying that in
Yes. Yes.
Pisto?
This is no, yeah, pisto.
Yeah, it looks like a pisto from here.
Mm.
That's
there's an angel.
Yeah.
Si. Que
palomita que
fish. Meeting in Roosevelt.
Yeah, Roosevelty.
Angel fish. Oh.
That's a big night fish.
Mm. Oh,
that's beautiful.
Wow.
My students love night fish, so.
I think everybody loves night fish.
You know, I've never been crazy about the night fish, to be honest.
Escalerica.
I can appreciate them, but I've never had them, and they just don't.
No, carne maya.
They don't look like off the Rio Nanay. They look like ornamental fish.
Borrachito.
Because they're small.
Oh wow.
That's a rummy nose, local Peruvian rummy
nose. Wow. That is. Wow, my goodness.
Rummy nose for a while. They're quite fussy to begin with.
Yeah.
Over it. Yeah, I have to get over it.
Well, the red on that nose is so.
Yep.
Well, the ones I had weren't from this country and they had the bodies.
They're Brazilian.
They were bright green bodies and they were gorgeous, but not very interesting.
It is bonito.
That is a beautiful rummy nose.
That's a big tetra.
Thing is, you can buy them though. My local shops are doing more and more wild stuff. You can buy wild stuff.
Mm. Wow, that's a beautiful geo. Oh, wow.
Heckley.
Heckley?
Okay, Mas. Okay, Pagre. Okay, Feliz. Novia. Okay, otra parte.
What have you spread the vertically
stuck? That is Leporinus.
Leporinus?
Yeah, they get about a foot long.
Really?
Yeah.
I saw a lot of those back
there. Aren't they?
No, yes?
No, it's not in hueco.
In hueco? Okay, here's a nice, this is a Sierra knife fish. Macana Sierra.
Tetra there, so you've got in there.
Oh, yep. Wow.
This is Pulcher.
Yeah, Pulcher is beautiful.
Beautiful.
They are, seeing them in the wild, they are beautiful as Pulcher.
The color on that geo is just amazing.
Jeez. The big ancestors last year, they were like this. Not
big as giant like that. Yeah, there you go.
Just okay. No.
And then with the guppy.
Female guppy, which are all over the place.
Back here.
Real Nanay betas? No.
Yeah.
¿Qué pistogramma acá?
Tapiche.
So these are some more tapiche. They will actually spawn. This is how he'll see. There's a big male there. They'll lay eggs inside these these PVC tubes. Where's that big male?
Really?
Wow. Yeah, it is.
That is massive. I've never seen
anything
like that.
This is a big old male.
Wow, wow, wow. Let's get
moving around.
All right, get my camera going. It'll take me 2 minutes to get this.
Hello.
Oh, come on, camera. Come on.
Good. These cages, the students are going to be working on Oscars.
Mm.
So, okay. So these are discus that we caught in Rio Nanay in a place in a sandy beach without any logs.
On a sandy beach?
In a sandy beach. In
yeah, this tells me that they're wedge-body grains?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, they're beautiful.
And by this, you mean this? What
the
gave
fin,
you that?
See the. Okay. The anal fin,
uh-huh. But it has a hell of a variety. When you get out to nature, you find that you can see the actual variety, don't you? And rather than what they put in the aquarium tray, which is just 1/10%.
Yep.
And are we doing what, brine shrimp?
No, brine shrimp or chlorella algae.
Algae, okay.
Yeah, for
green water.
Yeah, green. Okay. Here the students do a senior thesis, senior practicum, and a lot of students do it here. Until the research center is fully up and
gotcha.
So Carlos is an adjunct professor at UNOP, and so he has 6-7 students doing their senior capstone with him.
Well, I love this because this is like a setup you'd see in like a real hardcore fish nerds fish room setup right here.
So it sounds like this pond has got a lot of plecos in it.
Yep, but they're deep right now, so he can't.
Like kind of the standard plecos that we saw on the market, or like
pleco ranger.
Pleco ranger. Okay.
Yeah. Pleco ranger, see?
Alligator
plecos as well.
Alligator plecos, okay.
No meat.
Wow.
On the local orchids.
We're gonna try some natural honey.
No, I no honey.
No honey.
That's cool.
I think it's quiet.
Ah, see, I.
Poco.
Oh yeah, that's nice.
Bueno.
Wow.
Yeah, that's better than what I'd like.
You know, honey is one of those things forever.
That was delicious. I said this is one of this is their current breeding pond right now with some epistogrammas in there, and so we are gonna get some out and see what they have.
Okay.
My PhD is in snails.
Okay. Oh. Que es eso? Okay, so
dos
hembras. So this is an undescribed species of Epistogramma. So here's the female.
Oh wow. She's a decent size.
Epistogramma alto tapachi. Macho?
Can you give me a snail as well?
So this is the male alto tapachi.
Wow.
These are available at the exporters. Yeah. One exporter has them $25 a pair.
Wow.
Yeah.
And now we're gonna see some live escargot happen. So let's
but crunch. They'll eat a whole banana leaf.
Yeah, yeah.
And so some of the workers do it, and they collect the snails. And snails are a popular food here.
Okay.
You go into the
you could sell them. Could sell them down the market.
Yeah. But you go to the markets. They're softball sized. Okay. Some of the snails that they see. They use them in ceviche.
Okay. Yeah, they're very nice fish. I'm gonna try to take one home with me. I'll probably take one off the river. I'll catch.
Okay.
That was a beautiful, beautiful epistogramma. All right, so we made it to the Amazon Research Center. Took one of the moto taxis to get here. A little bit of a sketch ride at times, but you know, it's fun and enjoyable. 3 full-grown men cramped into the back that really should accommodate, you know, 1 or 1.5 people. It was good times. So now that we're here, gonna go into the lab, and this place is, you know, a lot of progress has been made as far as building it up. They still have more work to do, but it looks like so far, I mean, they've got a lot built. They've got a walled-in facility. There's more I can talk about that, like why walling in is so important. And actually, I can go ahead and tell you right now. So walling in is so important here because how it's been explained to me is they essentially don't have the private property protections that we would have in America or maybe somewhere else in the world. So if you have a piece of land and you're not using it, it basically invites squatters. So somebody can come and set up a home or, you know, whatever it is, use that land, And it just kind of becomes theirs. So walling in your facility, very important. So them accomplishing that, it sounds like actually on the other side of that fence right there, somebody had actually done exactly that. They set up a little home and kind of fenced it off, even though it was the Amazon Research Center's land. And, you know, kind of by the way things work here, it's now theirs. So that sucks. But let's go inside and see what they've got going on so far in the lab. Sorts of specimens and containers, gonads, and other bits of fish biology. You can't do real science without one of these guys, your microscope. Very important. Jar is actually a tilapia that they had collected in one of the streams here, and tilapia is not native here. Tilapia is native to Africa, and from my understanding, there is an aquaculture facility. They don't know which one, but one of the aquaculture facilities for a food fish has tilapia, and the fact that they're finding them in the wild, that's not good. It's, you know, it's basically an invasive species at that point. And it sounds like from the way Anthony's described it to me that tilapia can be a, you know, they're normally thought of as something that is kind of the vegetarian fish. You know, they're only going to eat plant matter, but when actually in the wild, they will eat whatever they can get a hold of, which would be small fish as well.
Good afternoon.
Yeah, good afternoon. Hello, good Dr. Afternoon. Anthony.
This will be the fish house, per se, where we'll be doing, you know, experiments on breeding. We have these raceways, and then over here will be all aquaria, and lined up along the wall will be aquaria as well.
Do you have any idea what species you're going to set up on?
When we work with the villagers, we're going to be working primarily with Pistogrammus.
Okay.
Okay. Maybe angelfish.
Yeah.
And we will be working primarily with catfish.
Okay.
Like Tigrinus cat, Lindsay cat.
Okay.
Trying to get some sustainable breeding going for them.
Okay.
And now those may look like pleco caves, but these are actually the bricks that they use. But any good aquarist worth their salt instantly sees that that's a pleco cave right there. And I would love to bring some of these home, but decently heavy, pretty bulky. Yeah, I don't know if this will be one of the souvenirs I take home or not. So you can see as I do a close-up of this wall, there's the brick. Walls and walls of pleco caves.
Carlos, he is our my resident manager. No habla inglés. Habla portugués.
Tu fala portugués?
Mais.
Um pouco.
Que pasa? Buenos días, ¿qué?
Antonio.
Antonio, sí. So this is a dorm room. Double occupancy. We'll have air conditioner, no air conditioner right now. So air conditioner. put a toilet paper down there.
Okay.
Oh, nice. Down on the toilets. Something that I just can't get used to.
Okay.
And this ladder is not off the shelf at Home Depot. This
nope.
very much looks like it was custom made.
Yeah.
That's a made on the job site ladder.
Gracias.
Yeah. We have a.
So let's take a count here. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 or 7 dorms.
So 4 dorms right now. The plan was to do 2 floors.
Yeah.
Money allowed us only to do 1 floor.
Okay.
So eventually there'll be 8 dorm rooms, double occupancy, and 1 apartment for if the professor brings his students here. The professor can have their own apartment. Primarily, it's going to be my apartment.
Mm-hmm.
So,
can somebody interested that's not necessarily in academia, they're not a student, they're not a professor, but they want to come down here and
yeah.
and stay with you? You,
yeah.
you okay,
yeah, yeah.
you do have availability
yeah.
for somebody like that?
Yeah. Some stairs right there.
This is the kitchen area. We're starting to build the cabinets. I'm a home carpenter, so I'm doing actually all this work that needs to come from there. So, you know, traditional style cabinets. And this is the dining room area, and then we'll have a little living room area back there.
So basically, if you come down here and do some research, you'll have all the amenities that you're used to when you come to the Amazon Research Center.
Even better.
Like, I'm pretty sure that's a better stove than what I have at home. So that's...
Yeah, that
would, actually,
got some good music going on.
A bathroom just right off the kitchen, so people won't have to go back to their rooms. And this is a laundry area. We'll have a washer. In the other building, a washer and a dryer.
Nice.
Which is very difficult to buy in this city.
Out of the post.
Yes.
Yeah.
And we can go on the roof.
So structurally, you could put a second story up there?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
It's structurally made for a second story already.
Add it later when you can.
Yeah.
And then this is where they film James Bond fight scenes when James is running around and he has to battle some bad guys.
And so that right there is our pump house for the well that we had dug. So we got fresh water, fresh drinkable water. We went down about 40 meters to get good clear water. Carlos, espera. And so the rebar, we're already set for the second floor to construction.
So we're going to have him wait to net out some fish? Or?
Well, yeah. We have some Pistogramma Alpha Capaci in there.
Nice.
That, you know, just a little breeding population in our reservoir. So I wanted you guys to see what it was. So eventually right here will be an auditorium. Classroom auditorium for 50, 60 people. On the other side will be a collections lab. We're gonna have collections of all the fish in the area. And that is our reservoir that we use for all the tank water and everything. And our aquarium will go up front, a big L-shaped aquarium, 25 meters, 15 meters and then a 10 meter L.
How are you doing on donations? Are you getting a significant amount of donations?
I wish I could say yes.
But it's not as tough on donations.
No, it's tough. It's tough for every nonprofit. You know, it's when you're an unknown quantity like we are, people don't, you know,
they want to throw money at
you. Yeah, no one, you know, who are you? Who, you know,
what are you doing?
I'm not, you know, the World Wildlife Fund, I'm not Greenpeace, you know.
Yeah.
It's difficult.
Check out this little bridge.
Well, after the 8.0 earthquake hit, we had to reinforce this wall.
Ah.
They felt it here. It was pretty significant here and here in Tupis. So yeah, you can walk across the bridge and go look on the other side.
Oh jeez, here we go.
Yeah, I'm old.
Here we go, here we go. Yeah, that's a bad idea. I'm not gonna do that.
Oh, come on. Get off my age.
All right, you gotta film me though, Neil.
I don't know how to do it.
Yeah, you just, it's already gone?
Yeah, I've got it,
Just point it at me.
Come on.
Here we go.
Go up there. Have we got sound as well?
Point it at me, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, he's so brave.
Research
cool.
Center.
Be a short trip. You go down there.
Yeah.
He's gone off.
I made it.